This is, for what it's worth, the world's first Mary Worth podcast. Sam and Eric use coarse language, and if you are offended by coarse language, please save yourself some trouble and cover your ears.
Hello, and welcome to For What It's Worth, the world's first and only Mary Worth podcast. My name is Sam.
And I'm Eric.
Eric, boy.
Yeah, some bad things went down last week.
I'm a little bit riled up, buddy.
Yeah, I can tell.
As you well know, I've been going on about it all week.
Yes.
We had that Hollywood phony Ryan Seacrest in here to record our intro for our fifth episode.
Yep.
He swore up and down he'd mention us both on his radio show. Yeah. And on E! News, didn't say a fucking word.
Can't believe that guy. I thought he was a professional, and I thought he would be good to his word, but no.
That Hollywood poser Ryan Seacrest, I would strangle him if he was in the room with me right now.
Ugh. So infuriating.
Ryan Seacrest, you take your perfect haircut and your pretty smile back to Hollywood and go fuck yourself.
God damn it.
God damn you, Ryan Seacrest, you cocksucker.
Go watch the ball drop, you bastard.
I'm gonna... He's made two very powerful enemies, Eric.
Yes, he has. I can't believe it.
Everybody else in the world is covering entertainment news. We're the only ones doing Mary Worth. We've got a monopoly. And when we're bigger than E! News, we're going to buy and sell him like the whore he is.
Thank God. Get him out of there.
I'm going to show that Ryan Seacrest the back of my hand.
Good idea. All
so,
right.
How about some Mary Worth news?
Yeah, that sounds good. Got to get our minds off of this.
This betrayal.
Oh, you are humiliated.
I'm not going to take this lying down, so I'm just going to start reading Monday's comic.
All right, good idea.
Mary gets ready for the party. I feel a special bond with Gina ever since I helped her. Stopping here.
Yeah?
That's not how mirrors work. Look at her hand in real life, and then look at the hand in the mirror.
Yep. It's the wrong way.
Yeah.
She's actually just looking at a picture of herself that's a framed photo.
Gina was so happy with her friendship with Mary that she has framed pictures of Mary all over the house. Giant murals and paintings.
Maybe it's not a mirror, maybe it's like an LCD screen. And it's on a slight delay.
Oh, that could be it, too. Because Bobby Black is rich. Mirrors have been around forever. He's got a hidden camera and a TV on the wall.
So screw that. Mirrors are for chumps.
A piece of polished glass, please. What is this, the Middle Ages?
And Mary's applying all of her mystical potions.
She's got several mystical potions and baubles and talismans.
What is that golden thing to her right? I don't know what that's supposed to be.
I think it's it looks a little bit like an urn.
Yes.
Maybe that's the late Mr. Worth.
Oh no.
Mary, you gotta let go.
Stop bringing it with you everywhere.
Jeff is really self-conscious about it. I mean, for obvious reasons. Like they're eating dinner at the Bumboat, and there sits dead Mary Worth's husband right there on the table, watching them, judging them.
Horribly grim.
Ah, Mary. I'm inspired by her rekindled love with Babby. One of the rare few things... Whoa! Piss. One of the rare few good things in the world.
Oh. Yep.
Yeah, doing another ear check. Making sure they're still on.
Yep, good. Okay. Got both my ears.
Yeah. Are we doing Tuesday?
Yep.
You're a lucky guy, baby.
I'm the lucky one.
Hey, we're both lucky. How many of us lose and then reunite with their true love in a lifetime, huh? Bobby Black. Cool guy.
What a cool cat that Bobby Black is.
Yeah, you like this tie? Probably cost more than your car. No big deal.
Alright, I guess it's Wednesday already.
Yeah, wow.
What do you think, Mary?
You've done well, Gina. I'm impressed by Baby. And so happy for you.
To signify that Gina is truly in love, she's got a heart pendant.
Oh, of course.
It doesn't count unless there's a heart pendant involved.
Yep.
Hey, you ready to make the, quote-unquote, special announcement, Bobby Black?
I've been ready for the past 10 years.
Mary looks a bit like a lizard.
Yeah.
I think it's just because Mary's making that face just because Gina turned away in, like, mid-sentence, just... Nope! Turned her back on Mary.
I don't know what Mary's looking at exactly. She's just sort of looking between them. I think Mary's looking over at the refreshment stand. It's like, oh, can I make a run over there, get one of those pigs in a blanket?
I imagine she's been there like 15 minutes maybe, and the party's already in full swing. And, you know, they serve some peanuts on the plane, and she's just parched. That punch bowl is looking delish.
How can I get over there?
How can I get over there and get a glass of punch for these two start yapping?
All right, Thursday.
I've loved Gina forever, even though for a while we weren't together. Bobby Black. Cool guy.
But time and circumstance could not change our feelings for each other. And, oh, I'm about to fall asleep. Good night. Why are her eyes... It's her eye have closed.
It's like one of those bad pictures you see at, like, a group event where somebody was caught in mid-blink.
Yep.
What's up with Gina's cheekbones? Her face is all swollen. She got the mumps?
Yep. Usual Maryworth slide face syndrome.
It's not a good look.
Who's that guy behind Mary in the second panel? He looks very worried.
Oh my gosh.
He looks very worried about something. He's just looking off to the side.
Oh. He's got this super wide, frowny mouth.
Poor guy. He doesn't want to be there at all.
Maybe this is the person whose house they've borrowed for the party, and he's come home early. Who are these people? Did I walk into the wrong house? Poor dude.
All right.
When are we on Friday?
Yep.
Dearest friends and family, I asked Gina to marry me, and she said yes. Bobby Black.
Go, Bobby!
Yay!
Background characters.
Have no names.
Geraldo's having a good time at this party. Right there.
He's got this disturbing quality about his glasses, though. He's like Elijah Wood in Sin City.
Yeah, he can't see anything past his glasses.
Ooh, terrifying. In a little bit, he's going to scratch Mary across the cheek with his long fingernails and then go read the Bible.
Oh, no. Ugh. What a creep.
We're getting married, huh? And the wedding is today. Wow, Bobby Black, cool guy.
Surprise.
Gasp. Gasp. Maybe they're, maybe they don't quite understand exactly how this works, but they're supposed to start chanting, speech, speech, speech.
Yes.
And instead, she's chanting, gasp, gasp, gasp. They're into it.
They aren't very smart guests.
I'd like to point out a fashion faux pas.
Yeah?
That dude to the left of Mary.
Yep.
You're not supposed to wear your tie longer than your shirt, buddy.
Oh, man.
You look like Fred Mertz.
I think the problem is he has pants hiked up way too high.
Yeah, thanks for coming to the party, White Urkel.
It's like, yay. He looks pretty happy about the whole thing.
Yeah, he's got his white cylinder there, so you know the party's in full swing.
I think he might be drunk.
If he was drunk, you know damn good and well that he would start cussing and screaming, because that's what always happens in Merry World when somebody's
over,
drunk.
And people would grab him and go, ah! You goddamn son of a bitch.
Marriage is a sham!
I hate all of you. I'm gonna punch this white-haired lady in the face.
I'm gonna get drunk and stoned and ruin the wedding!
I'll burn this whole place to the ground!
I'll burn this motherfucker down to ashes!
I think that's gonna happen next week.
Oh, I hope so.
he's only a little bit buzzed right now. He has to get full-on drunk.
He's just biding his time. Saturday?
Yep, Saturday. He apologized for the short notice, but Bobby's a celebrity. And we didn't want to. Wait. I didn't know where that sentence was going.
Oh, no, neither did I. I was right with you.
Okay, let's start over.
We'll cut that out.
He apologized for the short notice, but Bobby's a celebrity. And we didn't want press.
Why'd they invite Geraldo?
Yeah, now he's got kind of a Gene Shalit thing going on. I don't know what's going on with this guy with the mustache.
He has a shape-shifting mustache. It's very powerful, dark magic.
And also, George Takei is there.
Hey, George Takei!
What are you doing here?
Welcome to the party.
I'd say that Bobby's a celebrity.
Yeah, he's got all kinds of famous folks hanging around with him.
No, jeez.
If that was George Takei, though, wouldn't he have done that, oh my, thing instead of a gasp?
Yes. Yeah, but he wasn't in that panel.
So oh, okay, okay.
He was off panel somewhere.
Sometimes the staging makes the art suffer.
Only you guys are family and friends. To share our special day.
Will you join us outside for the ceremony, Bobby Black, cool guy? Come on, guys, let's go outside. It's a hip outdoor wedding.
Hey, you cool cats and kittens. Let's go out there and get hitched.
I guess I'm just gonna attach the old ball and chain out there in the flower garden. Just kidding, babe. Let's go. Bobby Black is too fucking cool.
He's too cool for school.
He has been my favorite member of the New York Blazes since I started following soccer.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
He's the best.
The soccer game.
All right, Sunday.
Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. Two souls, one heart. Last man standing walks away. Merry Worth, it's a French saying.
Did that work?
The French are always saying that.
Yeah.
Those crazy, crazy French.
Those crazy frogs. I'm so glad I encouraged Gina to look for Babby. She looked, and she found more than she ever dreamed of.
Oh, boy. Good for them.
I know. I'm happy for her. I was really worried about this last, you know, September when this was running.
Yep. No, I don't understand why the guests have to sit behind these gold statues.
It's like that creepy garden in Return to Oz with all the frozen stone people.
It's just a bunch of gold statues all over.
King Midas lived in the house they're having the party in.
They weren't expecting many guests, so they didn't want to feel like It was a whole sham. So, you know, they just got these statues.
They went down to the department store and drug out a bunch of mannequins and spray-painted them gold. Bobby was like, hey, babe, we gotta make them look gold so I look rich. Hey, Bobby Black, cool guy. That's his trademark.
That's what everyone loves him for.
That confident swagger. After announcing their engagement, Bobby and Gina surprise guests with their same-day wedding. The sudden timing may be a surprise, but for most of us who know this couple, the wedding itself is not. That's Patty O'Priest. Is his name? Oh. Because he's a priest standing out on a patio?
Yes.
This has been a long time a coming. Please repeat after me, Gina. Oi, Gina.
Hi, Gina.
Take you, baby.
Take you, baby.
My wife's... My fiance sure is pretty.
That's quite the dead-eyed staring at up there, Bobby.
Bobby Black, cool guy.
Oh, it's consummator marriage.
Hey, sweetie pumpkin, Bobby's feeling frisky.
I know it's supposed to be her hair hanging down over her ear, but yep. I just see a little elf ear.
Yeah.
Bobby Black has found his elf bride.
Aw, how lovely.
They're getting married in Middle Earth.
Oh, excuse me, I have to go back out into the dark forest. My other dark elf brethren live.
They're waiting for me. We're casting a spell.
Oh, boy. A spell of romance.
Ooh!
Do dark elves do that?
I'm not sure what dark elves do. I only know about regular elves.
I don't know much about fantasy fiction.
I know that when elves get married, it's usually a pretty big deal, because they live for, like, 600 years.
Oh. Let's hope Gina thought that one through.
Yeah, oh, yeah, definitely. Oh, nice. Well, that's just with like, Lord of the Rings elves, though. Other elves just, like, make cookies and fix shoes and shit.
Well, maybe she's that kind.
So she's gonna go from, being a waitress... to being a cobbler's assistant.
Yep.
Oh, dude, she can fix Bobby's cleats.
Yes.
Perfect. Match made in heaven.
Yes.
Why wouldn't a soccer star marry an elf?
He knows what he's doing.
He's got this one in the bag. Elf romance. So there's the end of the week.
That's it, I guess.
I guess.
Let's see how this marriage ends up.
Yeah, there's really nothing we can predict. I imagine the priest is going to say, to be your lawfully wedded husband on Monday.
Yep.
And they're going to go through the entire marriage vows, day yep. by day, panel by panel, we're gonna all be here. Next week.
We're going to be here for about two more weeks. So I hope you folks are ready for that.
There's going to be the marriage vows, the end of the ceremony next week, and then the priest is going to say, Bobby, I understand that you've written your own vows, and then he's going to take out a piece of paper, and there's going to be another week.
Oh, boy, that'll be great.
And then Gina's going to read her vows the next week.
Yep.
And then Mary's going to give a toast at the reception the week after that.
Yep.
And... it's just going to be a spiral on and on and on of people making speeches.
Yep.
There's my prediction.
Okay. That sounds like a good one. So, Sam.
Yeah?
What was your favorite moment this week?
Let's call it the worthy moment of the week.
Well, that sounds good.
be Bobby's crossed eyes in the last panel of Sunday's comic.
Yes.
It's very hard for me to take anything seriously when somebody in the vicinity is making that goofy face.
My worthy moment of the week would have to be Geraldo showing up at their wedding.
And God bless Geraldo, because they didn't want any press, so I imagine he's just there as a friend, not as a professional.
Yeah, that's good of him.
That Geraldo's a real class act.
Yep.
When he's not, you know, letting the insurgents know where American troops are in Afghanistan.
Well, I think you have to, you know, let some slide.
You know, everybody makes mistakes.
All right.
Thank you to you people for listening to our podcast.
Yep, thank you very much.
So, thank you, Mom, and Eric, thank you for listening.
Oh, you're welcome.
I usually listen from work and from at home, so there's at least two more listeners there.
Yep, let's go.
Thank you to Wanders from Mary Worth and Me. Go to maryworthandme.blogspot.com. Read his blog every day like I do.
Yes.
Thank you to the Aquabats for the unauthorized use of their song Sequence Erase for our theme song. Please don't tattletale on us. I don't want to get in trouble.
Nope, don't
tell somebody
them.
Tattles on us, they're going to say that the audio was removed from this video for copyright infringement.
We didn't
know anything about that. We didn't infringe on anybody's copyright. We just didn't ask permission.
That's a good song. Please don't take it from us.
Don't take it from us. We'll be so upset. And I'd like to thank the Robot Beach Boys for a MIDI of California Girls that we play at the end of the show.
Yes.
And I would like to offer negative thanks, the opposite of what a thank is, to that snake Ryan Seacrest.
That bastard. That horrible, horrible trickster.
I would not shed a tear if I found out that he finally realized what a lying crook he was and threw himself off the top of a building and splattered on the pavement and into 1,000 pieces and died because I hate him. Fuck you, Ryan Seacrest. You jerk.
What a horrible, horrible man. I feel sick.
Ryan Seacrest, we're going to make sure you end up in jail for lying to us. Like Mexican jail. Really bad jail.
Oh, dear.
Jerk. Are we done with the show?
Yep.
Good. I need to cool off. My name is Sam.
And I'm Eric. And remember, if marriage were outlawed, only outlaws would have in-laws.
And that was your week in Merry Worth. For what it's worth. That was your week in Merry Worth, for what it's worth!
Want to do a second thing? That ending?
Yeah.